This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. HMNZS Canterbury is a multi-role vessel MRV of the Royal New Zealand Navy. She was commissioned in June 2007, and is the second ship of the Royal New Zealand Navy to carry the name, the first ship having been a Leander-class frigate. She is also New Zealand's first purpose-built strategic sealift ship. However, the vessel has been plagued by problems since delivery, having been involved in a number of incidents and being considered less seaworthy than specified. It is estimated as of 2008 that at least another 20 New Zealand dollars. 42 facilities, 5 issues, 51 problems with RHIBs and landing craft, 52 sea keeping performance, 6 see also, 7 references, 8 external links, planning and design, further information. Project Protector. As early as 1988, the Royal New Zealand Navy had identified the need for some form of sealift in the South Pacific. In 1995, this led to the commissioning of HMNZS by Tenex Shipyards in Williamstown, Melbourne, with the design based on the commercial RoRo ship Ben Micree. However, the choice of a commercially based design has been criticized after the ship was delivered, as it placed several limitations on the functionality of the ship in rough seas, rather than the coastal environment for which Ben Micree was designed. The keel was laid on 6 September 2005 and the MRV was launched successfully on February 11, 2006. The ship completed initial sea trials in the Netherlands and arrived in Australia in late August 2006 for fit-out with military equipment. Final acceptance was delayed due to alterations to the ship's hospital and late delivery of documentation. There were also ongoing concerns, negotiations and redesign activities regarding her performance in heavy seas, doubts about which had already been thrown up during her initial journey to Australia, and in fact, even before actual construction. The MRV was accepted by the New Zealand government on 31 May 2007 and commissioned on 12 June 2007 in Port Melbourne, Australia by the Prime Minister of New Zealand, Helen Clark. The ship cost $130 million New Zealand dollars to construct. She was constructed with an ice-strengthened hull to allow her to operate in the subantarctic waters, where New Zealand claims several islands, and where Canterbury is to assist scientific expeditions. Operational history. Initial exercises and operations. After commissioning, the ship sailed to its home port of Lyttelton, arriving 28 June 2007. After several days of inaugural events, it departed again on 2 July following a courtesy visit to Timaru, and after a month-long set of trials and exercises in the Auckland area, where she is operationally based at Devonport Naval Base, she is to head to New Zealand's subantarctic waters carrying dock conservation officers in September 2007. Canterbury embarked 250 troops and 50 vehicles, including 20 NZLAV armored vehicles, to test embarkation and disembarkation procedures. ONZ Disaster Relief Response Force. In early 2011, it was announced that the ship would form the core asset of a joint Australia-New Zealand task force for disaster relief operations. At that time, Canterbury was the only vessel available to the navies of the two countries suitable for such tasks, as three other similarly capable Australian ships were unavailable due to significant maintenance problems. Coincidentally, the newly appointed disaster relief ship was in the port of Lyttelton less than 2 weeks later during the devastating February 2011 Christchurch earthquake. The crew provided meals for 1,000 people left homeless in that town, and accommodation for a small number of locals. 2012 Kermadec Islands eruption and pumice raft. HMNZS Canterbury was the first ship to take scientific samples from a 7,500 to 10,000 square mile pumice raft that was discovered in the Kermadec Islands. 2016 Kaikoura earthquake. After the earthquake on 14 November 2016, HMNZS Canterbury was deployed to provide relief for Kaikoura, as extensive damage to major roads severely restricted access capabilities. Armaments. The M242 Bushmaster cannon fitted to Canterbury's foredeck is the primary weapon fitted to the sealift ship. As a sealift ship, Canterbury is not intended to enter combat, or conduct opposed landings under fire. The ship's armament consists of a single 25. The ship has cargo space of 1,451 square meters, 15,620. Intended to be able to access beaches in the Pacific where no port facilities are available, for example during humanitarian missions due to various issues discussed further below, the original landing craft were decided in 2010 to need replacing. The fate of the current craft is currently undecided. HMNZS Canterbury alongside at Lyttelton in 2007, an SH-2G Seasprite is sitting on the dockside helicopter facilities. Canterbury is able to accommodate up to 4 NH-90 helicopters for deployment ashore in support of New Zealand Army operations and disaster relief activities. She is also capable of operating the SH-2G Seasprite, and the helicopter deck is able to handle a Chinook-size helicopter. Medical Canterbury has a 5-bed hospital ward, a 2-bed sickbay, an operating theatre, a medical laboratory and a morgue. Others. The ship also contains a gym, workshops, an armory and magazine, as well as offices for government officials embarked such as Department of Conservation or NIWA scientists. Issues. The ship has been plagued by a number of issues, most of them related to faulty design, or design inappropriate for the intended operating conditions. Problems with RHIBs and landing craft. Canterbury weathered her first strong storm during the 10th of July 2007 well, though she lost one of her rigid hulled inflatable boats RHIB and almost lost the other to waves swamping her open boat bays while near Tauranga on the way to Auckland. The RHIB was found a week later, washed ashore on Great Barrier Island, 200 kilometers 120. Roll frequency of 115 seconds. The ship's anti-roll system will not function when the period of the ship's roll is less than 119 seconds. As a result, work was begun to relocate the boats to a less vulnerable location in October 2007. A crew member was killed when an RHIB capsized whilst being lowered into the sea. The Navy immediately began an inquiry into the accident. Defense Minister Phil Goff later reported that it was caused by the failure of a quick-release shackle, which was now being replaced on all naval vessels. In November 2007, Lieutenant General Jerry Matepere said that certain issues were being discussed with the shipbuilder, including the location of the RHIB on the quarterdeck from which it was torn off during the storm in July, possible fatigue problems with the landing craft fittings, and some other issues. New Zodiac inflatable sea boats were ordered from Tenex Australia to replace the two Gemini sea boats that were damaged in 2010. It was decided that two new landing craft would have to be built for Canterbury, as they had experienced a variety of issues, from material problems experienced with weak bow ramps, to stability problems, which severely curtailed their usability. The Australian builders of the ship, Bay Systems, agreed to pay $85. In 2013, two new shell doors on Deck 3, and two new accommodation ladders on Deck 5 were designed and installed by Taranaki engineering firms ITL and EHL Marine Industrial Design, and Babcock NZ made the necessary structural changes. The RHIB was able to be relocated as a result of the innovative design of the new accommodation ladders, which can stow compactly inside the ship 5 by 25 by 25 meters, rather than being externally stored alongside the ship as before. Improved design of the ladders and the relocation of the RHIB has increased the safety and capability of the ship. Is no longer compromised. Sea keeping performance. In September 2008, an independent review of the safety and functionality of the ship revealed that some operating limitations will have to be accepted, as sea keeping performance is poor in high sea states. The selection of a commercial roll-on, roll-off RORO design has been at the root of differences of opinion between Tenex, the Ministry of Defence and New Zealand Defence Force, and the shortfalls in performance. The issues included that the propellers can come out of the water when the ship pitches in rough sea, with concern that this may affect the ship's machinery. The report also recommended relocating the ship's boats or protecting them from waves if relocation was not possible, and adding more ballast or improving the ballasting system of Canterbury. These upgrades have now been completed. The RHIB alcoves are now further forward and higher, and more ballast has been added to help with sea keeping. This was all completed before the Pacific Partnership 2013 exercise. The bridge during Pacific Partnership 2011 aft well deck consultation room of the infirmary. See also logistic ships of the Royal New Zealand Navy. HMNZS Carrot AB first of Navy's $500 million worth of new vessels ready to report for service. The New Zealand Herald NZPA 6 June 2007 retrieved 3 October 2011. Carrot soldiers get a taste of the sea. Hawke's Bay today, Saturday the 22nd of September 2007. Carrot Ansley, Greg the 12th of February 2011 NZ, Australia to set up Crisis Response Centre. The New Zealand Herald retrieved 13 February 2011. Carat design fault known before ship delivered, the Dominion Post, Saturday 22 December 2007 Carat AB run down Army has no backup battalions, the Dominion Post, Friday 23 November 2007 Carat Navy's new ship stays tied up until new sea boats arrive, New Zealand Press Association, 15 September 2008 Carat landing craft useless. The New Zealand Herald 15 April 2010 retrieved 18 June 2011.